Well, I don't have any prepared speeches because, as you can see, we've been building the building until about 14 minutes ago. Luckily, I live close. I just wanted to say welcome. There's a couple things going on here today. First and foremost, in my mind, is spark. When Lisa and John came to me, as they said, they had this idea, and I was still stuck with what some people call a vision of the building. Some people call it a delusion or insanity or what have you. It's a close call. Although today I think we're at least leaning towards vision. But they had a vision. They had a vision of what could be here. You know, what was here was a beautiful school for 90 years that truthfully probably had outlived itself, its effective life as a school. But as a building, it's beautiful. As a property, it's beautiful. It's an absolutely essential part of the community. Spark fits in there because Spark should be right here in the middle of the community, front and center in the building. Thank you. They should be here. It shouldn't be off in the suburbs. It shouldn't be out on 12A. It shouldn't be up on the hill that where no one can walk to. It should be a place where everyone can get to it and everyone can see it. And it's part of the wider community. I'm surprised it didn't exist. I am very proud and pleased to be associated with these people because they put this together. We put a building together. That's a different challenge and a different achievement. They put this together, which is even harder because they started with absolutely nothing except energy and passion. And I share that, and I admire that. Right. I want to say to everybody, you know, later come on in the building. We're having our open house. Wander up, say hello. I wanted to say thank you for what you've done here. Thank you for working with me. These guys have learned a lot. I've learned a lot here. It's hard. You know, they say anything worth doing is hard. This must have been worth doing. It's still worth doing. That said, I just wanted to welcome everyone here, introduce these guys to you, John Fenley, Lisa Green, and Spark.
That guy gives a good hug. I have to really raise these things up. Huh?
Yeah, I gotta put it down.
Good thing this is built for John's.
So welcome everybody. Thank you so much for coming, especially with all of, you know, this going on. I apologize, but you know, hey, you gotta roll with it. It's a work in progress. So we welcome you here and thank you for all your support.
Nothing brings tears of joy to your eyes like the fresh smell of tarmac being laid down.
You'll always remember it next time you smell tar. So today's program is we're going to have some presentations here, and then we're going to all walk hand in hand to our entrances. We have the main entrance and the handicap entrance. We're going to walk hand in hand through it like a finish line, and we're going to have Pam play the Chariots of Fire theme song as we do it.
It's going to be epic.
And then at 5:30-ish, we're going to do the barbecue. You guys help yourself. There are cheeseburgers and burgers for $3, hot dogs for $2, and side things for $1 or whatever, okay? And we have lots of water in the back, guys, that is free. So just, if you're thirsty, you just go in the back and you'll see a bunch of coolers. Help yourself to water, okay?
Stay hydrated. We don't want to make the news for people passing out. We want to make the news for the grand opening.
Yeah. And then we have two porta-potties in this back corner, kind of behind that arc black thing, okay?
Only the classiest for you guys.
Because, you know, the bathrooms inside are not quite ready. All right, so we also have, and then next at 7 o'clock is the big dance, right? We're going to have a dance. We're going to dance inside and outside on this freshly paved area. So I hope you can all join us for that.
So we also have a lot of opportunities if you want to support Spark Community Center. I know so many of you are already here because you know about us and you support us. And who would we be to turn down money? I mean, this really is a community effort. So in the event that you have a surplus of cash in your wallet and just really have to get rid of it, we have some raffles.
Yes.
My mom and some other great ladies made some quilts. We have
Colleen
and Teresa made two quilts.
Beautiful handmade quilts.
My mom, Madeline Botter, and Rita Tingle also made the other one, and they'll be on display. Theirs inside. Oh, we have the other quilt right here. And then other raffles we're going to have are gift baskets. And of course, you all know about our fundraiser to sell Spark t-shirts, Spark logo t-shirts. You probably see them floating around here. They're pretty cool.
They're on sale today for $15.
Yeah, forget $19.99. It's changing and change and just $15.
Yeah, $15.
And then, of course, we have our Buy a Brick campaign. There's a beautiful brick wall in our space, and we want to load that up with names of people to show our participants how much you all care so deeply about it. And I know many of you have already bought a brick, and we thank you for that. And
we're going to have the opening.
You may want to know that this is also the opening of our annual meeting, our first annual meeting. But we're not going to sucker you into like a long board meeting. It's really low key. We're just going to announce a few officers and stuff.
And that's all. Yeah.
And then we can just party. Yeah. We gotta. You know.
Yeah.
And then, of course, one of the things we want to do right now is thank the major sponsors who really helped make this a reality. Kathleen Dolan, the Byrne Foundation, the Pierce family, Granite United Way, and the Masons, and there's so many others of you out there who've made donations, so we just want to give you all a round of applause. Thank you
so much. All right, so next, before we go any further, we've invited Pastor David Woltower up, and he's going to do the invocation today.
Good afternoon. I wanted to give a blessing today to this event, to this community, and to the project that is going on here. And every blessing is appropriately started with thanksgiving. So first, I would like to thank John. I would like to thank Lisa for taking a vision and running with it and blessing our community by what God put in their hearts. This is going to be a wonderful, wonderful place here and doing a great work for us. I'd like to speak a blessing on those that this work, for those who are going to participate, those who have need that this is going to meet. A blessing on all the staff and all the volunteers who come through these doors. A blessing on all who come to participate in the services here. May God grant you success in all its endeavors, strength and grace to all the workers, and abundant joy to all who come here. Amen.
Next, John's going to sing a little ditty for us.
Yes. I left my iPad inside. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not going to sing a little ditty. I'll sing it for you guys later at the dance.
That sounds good.
Sorry.
And there's one thing I forgot to mention. Senator Shaheen sent Bethany Urich to come here today, and she brought a letter that she'd like to read to us.
Awesome.
Wow, good afternoon. I guess this space really filled in while I was seated down here in the front. This is impressive. I am very honored to be here today. Senator Shaheen would love to have been able to be with us all. However, her schedule did not allow that to happen. But she does send a letter that I'd like to read for you. It says, "Dear friends, thank you for inviting me to today's grand opening for the Spark Community Center. I am sorry I cannot be with you for today's opening, but I would like to extend my congratulations for the completion of this project. Today is a very special day for Spark. As a result of the tireless work by volunteers and community members, as well as the generosity of various donors, this facility stands as a monument to what can be accomplished when people work together toward a well-defined goal. Spark will serve this city well in coming days and months and years. Projects like this one represent the best in private and public sector partnerships. Spark Community Center would not have been possible without the focused planning and cooperation of so many contributors and team members. Because of these efforts, children and adults from across the region will have access to recreational opportunities for decades to come. Congratulations on a job well done. I look forward to hearing of Spark's continued success. Sincerely, Jean Shaheen, United States Senator. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
I guess we have a few introductions to make. Premier among them, actually, is who the heck is this guy next to us here? What's... Oh, that's Sparky. This is Sparky, guys. Yeah. He actually sent me an email the other day. He's like, I really want to come to the event, but I need to make sure that the tent is big enough because, you know, I'm embarrassed about the size of my head. I don't want to set it on fire with any sparks, so... I was like, no, we'll get the right size tent, it'll be fine, and we're just glad he can make it out today. This is our lovable mascot for the Spark Community Center, and you might see him throughout town, throughout the year, promoting some of our big events for the whole community. So it's kind of surreal for me, because when I drew the logo and drew Sparky the spark plug, I didn't actually think that I'd get an email from him, you know. I was like, wow, he actually is out there. So, yeah. So,
all
thanks.
Right.
High five.
So we'd also like to introduce the staff. So Lindsay Pierce over there. Lindsay, say hi. She's an activity specialist. We've hired an executive director. His name is Brett. Brett, where are you? Right over there.
Yeah, Brett.
Brett Mayfield. We've got Sam. Sam Crowan, where are you, Sam? He's on a mission, I guess.
He's out there.
We've got some people running emergency errands.
Protecting the innocent.
Yes. So Sam's another one. And we've got Molly O'Hara. Where are you, Molly? Yeah! So Molly's going to be in charge of volunteer and marketing stuff.
Yeah, we're going to need lots of volunteers. So if you're interested, go hit up Molly for some class ideas.
And then last but not least, we've got this young man, John Fenley, who's going to be in the activity staff as well.
It's going to be fun.
All right, so we just want to briefly discuss an overview of what, you know, we're going to do at Spark, okay?
Yeah, we got to lay out the vision,
yeah,
the dream.
Man. So yeah. We've got all kinds of classes we're going to offer, you know, like life skill classes as well as fun classes. So if any of you have like a particular skill or expertise and you want to teach the group, you could come volunteer and teach a class for us.
Totally.
That'd be so awesome. And we're going to get this wonderful smart board, hopefully someday, if we can get a good funder to help us out. We want to make that the centerpiece of the center so we can use the internet technology and the whiteboard, you know, they have all this technology.
It's a great digital, like, interactive screen that we can mount on our wall and use for classes.
Exactly. So we can have a really high-tech presentation because a lot of our learners are visual learners. And there's so much content on the internet that we want to take advantage of.
And most exciting, one of the most exciting things is we're going to be having lots of special events. So we hope to keep seeing a lot of you tried and true supporters of Spark come out for more of them. Special events like, I mean, why is there no comic book convention around here? There's nerds out here. There's a good nerd population. I'm one of them. Star Wars conventions, am I right? Do we have any Trekkies in the room? Any Trekkies? I know you're out there.
They don't want to admit it.
We got like three intermittent claps there. But anyways, no, we're going to have stuff like that. We're going to bingo, dances, karaoke, theater productions and musicals, but also special events for the whole community as well. Like, you know, during Halloween, let's have a big jack-o'-lantern carving day right out here in the field for all of our families and families of the community. Sky's the limit. If we can imagine it, we'll try to make it happen because we want to be an ever-present presence within the community of Lebanon and the Upper Valley, and that's one of our missions.
So just check out our website. We'll always try to update it. You can always find out what's going on. Matter of fact, on the 4th of July, we've got this major to-do, okay? So starting at 9 o'clock in front of the Senior Center here in Lebanon, we're going to be having a massive yard sale. So those of you who want to come set up a table and sell some of your stuff, you're welcome to come because the Senior Center and the Rotary Club are having their big annual pie sale, which brings a lot of people, and they've given us their entire parking lot to use it as a fundraiser.
So you can have your pie and eat it too.
Huh.
Hey Sparky, are you going to be there?
And so
you're available? All right.
That'll be from 9 to 1:30, and then starting from 2 to 5 right here on the field, we're going to do all kinds of old-fashioned, nice field games, you know, like the three-legged race and the sack race and the egg thing and all kinds of fun games.
The egg thing. You guys know what we're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about. And And then at 7 o'clock, we're going to have a great dance, all right? So we hope that you can join us for that.
And then we have some big plans. Plans beyond just the space indoors, which is gorgeous when you see it. You're going to be blown away. But as a matter of fact, behind this tent, off in the corner over there, we are planning to break ground on a garden. We want to have a community garden that can serve the entire community and really be an inspiration to people. And I think one of the things that's going to be great about it is for the first time, we're going to try to create one that is wheelchair accessible, so truly everyone can participate.
Yeah. So we haven't gotten around to doing that yet because we had a lot on our plate, but we'll get to it. And so maybe this time next year, you're going to see some gorgeous gardens.
It's going to be really cool.
Yeah. We have done a lot of meeting with a whole bunch of people, lots of other nonprofit organizations here in the area. So we're going to do all kinds of partnerships and collaborations with various organizations like Global Campus, Zach's Place, the Special Needs Support Center, Pathways, Volk Rehab, VINS, the Tucker Foundation at Dartmouth. We're doing all kinds of fun projects.
And one of our goals that we have is to really get the full community and all of our businesses behind our participants. So one of the things that Lisa and I discussed was the idea of creating a Light a Spark campaign. And
kind of like Make a Wish, you know.
Yeah, and the Light a Spark program would be with local businesses where they would try to find out what are some dreams that people want to have made true. Sometimes it could be as simple as, you know, we have a participant who would love to ride in a fire truck. Well, there's got to be a way to make that happen, right?
Yeah.
So these are ways that we can make, you know, people reach their highest expectations and dreams and make those come true.
Yeah, want to put a smile on their face. So we're also going to be offering a member discount program where we've already talked with several organizations in the Upper Valley that have entertainment or kind of recreational things, such as AVA, Upper Valley Aquatic Center, CCBA, Lebanon Opera House, VINS, Montshire, and so much more. We're going to partner with them to offer a discount for people with special needs. And if that person with special needs requires an aid, right, that person's going to be free or very low cost because really they're working. And, you know, buying two tickets has always prohibited a lot of folks who are on a very limited income to go and participate in our community. So we're just going to try to open up some opportunities there.
I think for a lot of people, there's already an existence that if you have, if you're a person with special needs, you could ask to get the senior discount. But I don't know. I don't feel right going up and saying, can I have the senior discount? I have a disability. I mean, that's kind of like just putting it all out there.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, it's like, geez, do I have to, you know, take you out to dinner to get membership or something? I don't. So, you know, instead what we're going to do is, you know, you also don't want to go and be like, I'm part of the disability program.
Yeah.
So this is the Spark program. And we want everyone to participate, which is why we're calling it the Sparkticipation program.
Yeah, and we're going to have little cards to make it easy on all these organizations. So you just show them your Spark card. John, show them the Spark card.
Yeah.
Yeah. It needs to be laminated, but we have our first member right here.
Johnny Depp,
man.
You think he'll come pick it up?
Yeah.
Eventually.
I'm counting on it.
Send him an email.
Yeah. So we skipped that one. Go for it.
Oh, yeah. So we're going to actually have a deal worked out with the local Lebanon Rec Department, and we're also communicating with a lot of other recreation departments in all the surrounding areas in Vermont and New Hampshire. We want to make sure that there is easy accessibility to all the programs that our local communities have to offer. So we've designed a stamp, a sort of template, if you will, that will go in their program books that has Sparky giving a good thumbs up. Show them how that goes, Sparky. There you go. Yeah, it's just like that. It's amazing how he does
that. So for example, if your loved one, you know, is 22 years old and he wants to participate in a beginning guitar class, but it's for ages 5 to 8, well,
most parents would say, oh, well, missed opportunity for my child that's 20, but would love to do that.
But we're going to put a Sparky approved on that so they know any age group with a special need can participate.
Why not, right? Why not? And the best part is we even came up with a cool, kitschy phrase for that, too. We're calling it our Sparks and Rec program. You'll get it later, I'm sure.
All right, so So that's kind of it in, you know, a broad overview, our beginning efforts. So you see the path we're on. So next, what I'd like to do is introduce some of our board members and officers and kind of conclude that annual meeting formality stuff. So our
we swear this is the most boring part of the whole thing.
It's only going to take a second.
Bear with us.
So we have a board of 8 members. They are Philip Eller right there, who's representing Special Needs Support Center.
Yeah, Philip.
We've got Pam Fitzgerald representing Global Campus on our board.
Yeah, Pam.
Ooh, Pam. We got Jose Braden. Jose, where are you, man?
Where you at, Jose?
Oh, there he is. All right.
Yeah,
Jose. We've got Kimberly LaBarge. Kim, say hi.
Woo. Yeah.
We've got Elizabeth Larson, who couldn't be here today. And we also have Sue Moretti, who couldn't be here today. And then myself. Did I get everybody?
Sean.
Sean. Sean. I'm sorry, Sean.
Sean
Marlowe, the best one.
Yeah. Yes, Sean.
So what I'd like to do, board members, is I'd like to ask for a motion to approve the current slate of board members. And we're nominating Phil as secretary, Sean as treasurer, Lisa as president, and Elizabeth as vice president. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
All right. Second it. All right. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any abstainer, you know, knows? Okay. All right.
That's more like it. Yeah.
We're done with the annual meeting.
Democracy in action, people.
All right, John.
Okay. So, we're all about celebrating the human spirit and celebrating the incredible gifts that everyone has to offer. I mean, that is, after all, why we named this Spark, right? Everyone has a spark deep down inside worth sharing with their community. What kind of opening ceremony would it be if we didn't actually show to you some of this amazing human spirit right here at our grand opening? So, Kelly, could you come up for a minute? Hi, Kelly. Kelly is a very close friend of mine. She is part of my local self-advocacy group, and she's an embodiment, I feel, of courage and determination. And we are going to be playing a amazing digital story that she created in our space. Once you get to tour the space, we'll have it on the wall, and it'll be really good. So I don't know if you want to say a few words, Kelly.
Well, John actually encouraged me to do it. He says you should really do it. I did it, and yeah, I think you really do good. So I did it. So.
Check it out when you go inside. It'll be on a loop. We'll have it on a loop.
Yeah.
And then we're also about celebrating achievements and success and the power of teamwork. And there's actually an amazing story that a good friend of mine, Kyoki Johnson, has been working on producing this short film about Travis Stover and Kim Stone.
Travis and Kim, are you here?
Travis and Kim?
They might not, okay.
They may not have been able to make it, but...
Let me just tell you briefly what it's about. So Kim is the mom and Travis is the son. I think he's like 25 or so. And he's always had a dream of having his own place. He's got special needs, you know, so he's worked with the whole team during his earlier years in school. And then his mom's always rooting him, and he's just an amazing guy. She could tell this story, like, when she brought him home, because he was adopted. He was just a little peanut. Everybody thought he wouldn't make it. And here he is. He's thriving. So it's a great story about how he had a goal, and they broke it down into the steps you have to take to achieve your goal. And the team members you need to recruit to come help you. It's a great success story, really. And, you know, I talked to Kim. I said, Kim, you're so inspiring. She goes, really? I don't think so. And I want to encourage parents to step back and show the mirror, look at what you've achieved, and celebrate that success. So that's why we wanted to do this film. And Kyoki is just, he's a great guy, and he's a wonderful film producer, director, maker.
And he was actually
the perfect guy for it.
He was one of my first direct support providers to help me live a sustainable life in the community independently. You know, most people don't know I have a disability, and that's because of people like him and so many other DSPs, many of you of whom are here today. Can we give a quick round of applause for DSPs?
Absolutely.
Let's give a quick
round. Absolutely.
Yeah. So not only is he a movie maker, he works one-on-one with so many of the people we'll
Absolutely.
Be serving.
Absolutely. Absolutely. All right. So the next part of our program is really fun. Mike, come on up. So Spark you know, we've been working, you know, for 9 months, basically, and we've had some amazing support from three organizations and individuals in this area.
We could not have done this alone.
We could not have, and they have shown such dedication and commitment despite all kinds of barriers. And we want to recognize these people, and we've created an award. And so the first one, well, first of all, I want to read the five ideas.
So we were thinking a lot about what we should name this award, and we decided to call it the Spark High Five Award. And the Spark High Five Award embodies five ideals that we look for in local organizations and candidates that would be chosen.
They are. They support Spark Community Center and its mission. They work tirelessly to make our community a better place for all. They believe in a strong community where everyone has an opportunity to participate. They inspire and empower people with special needs to achieve their full potential, and they celebrate that everyone has a spark worth sharing with the world. Our first recipient is Mr. Mike Davidson, with Executive Suites.
Thank you very much.
You want to take a picture of us?
Yes,
all right. And Sparky in here, too.
That's going to light us up.
Thank you. We're going to take a shot in a second. All right.
But wait, there's more.
There's more. There's two more.
we also want to thank Benta Torgerson with Ava Gallery for just being an amazing support.
We had an awesome March event, right? Some of you were there.
That March event was amazing. Benta.
Benta, come on down.
Come on down, girl.
Where is she?
She's not here.
She left? Oh, man.
Ah.
Benta.
We'll embarrass her again in a few minutes.
Yeah. All right. And our final recipient is Mr. Charlie Thorault. Charlie with the Masons, come on down.
Charlie!
So Charlie's part of the local Masonic Lodge, and they're doing this picnic, they helped us for the March launch, they've helped us in so many ways.
And they're cooking your dinner.
And he needs a little recognition.
Good to see you again.
Obviously the two people that are most instrumental in creating Spark and getting the energy involved in this is a dream that parents have been having in our community for at least 20-30 years, and it's finally come to pass. And I want to just sort of give a little recognition to Lisa Green.
Yeah.
And to John Finley. And let's give them a big hand.
I'm worried. I don't know if I'm going to be able to keep these alive. But they're gorgeous, though. I do not have a green thumb. We might have to put these on the desk in the office.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Phil. That's amazing.
Yeah. We're almost on the home stretch here, guys, and then we can all go inside. So we're going to conclude our presentation today with the Global Campus Singers. So you Global Campus Singers, come on up front. Yay. All right. So while they're coming up front.
Yeah, I just want you guys to know that after this performance, we're all going to walk hand in hand to the brand new Spark entrance.
Stacey,
there's a Spark main entrance here, and on the other side, a Spark handicap entrance, and we will officially open the center together. We could have gotten up, Lisa and I, and been all pompous and used giant scissors, but we feel like this has been a long journey, so let's all cross the finish line together, right? Thanks, guys.
All right.
We're going to hand it over to these guys.
Go right in front here, guys. Right in front here. And I forgot their lyrics, so they're just going to wing it, okay? I think they kind of know it by now. And I encourage everyone to join in. Yep.
like a plastic bag, drifting through the wind, wanting to start again. Do you ever feel so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens where no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you? You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just own the night like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show them what you're worth. Make them go as you shoot across the sky. Your original cannot be replaced. If you only knew what the future holds, after a hurricane comes a rainbow. Maybe a reason why all the doors are closed, so you could open one that leads you to the perfect road. Like a lightning bolt, your heart will glow, and when it's time you know, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just own the night like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby, you're a firework. Come on, show them what you're worth. Make them go as you shoot across the sky.
Let's cross this finish line together, everyone. Sparky, you want to lead the way? Let's do this. I love you too, man. Let's lead the way. Hey guys, we have Kiyoki here before we cross the finish line, just to say a few quick words about the film that he made.
Yeah. Come on, Kiyoki.
Come on over, Kiyoki.
You can do it. This is the Kim and Travis film we talked about.
Yeah.
This is Kiyoki.
Hello, we don't know the spikes and it will be serving an underserved population and providing people with something to do in Lebanon. All right. Back. Okay. But Lisa wanted me to do a documentary, which isn't done playing yet, but it will be by September.
Right.
This documentary is about this man named Travis Stone and his mom, Kim Stone. And this center is going to be a touchstone for Travis, and it will be one of the centers of his social life. Travis was born with a disability. I'm not going to give it away. I want you to see what he did in this documentary. And with that disability, he was able to go to public school, graduate from high school, and become a full-time employee at DHMC
and
the custodial part of DHMC. He's been working there for 7 years, and he's only 25 years old. He's got goals beyond most 25-year-olds. Instead of wanting a big screen TV, loud stereo, or fast car, he wants to build a house for himself and three of his friends with staff. And it's going to be up the street here in Lebanon.
Yeah.
Without the Spark Center, he and his friends would have very little to do because they would have to take a bus to the movies, take a bus to the malls. But thanks to the Spark Center, they can go down the street, literally right three doors down, and be with all their friends. And this will be one of the focal points of his social life. It's going to make him possible to be successful in his own home that he paid for, that he had built from the money he works for at his job. Isn't that the goal that we all want for everyone? Paid employment, their own house, their own independent life.
And he's making it happen.
He's making it happen.
Yeah, right on. Yeah.
Okay,
thank you,
everybody.
Guys. So let's cross that finish line.
Let's all hold hands and walk that finish line. We got two ways you can go in, the main entrance and the handicap entrance.
Guys, heard you ain't coming tomorrow. Heard you ain't coming tomorrow.
We just got in the way.
Should we give it a countdown?
Yeah, right.
On the count of three.
Oh yeah.
One, two, three.
Lead us in.
Oh, you want me to go?
Yeah.
Lead
us in.
Oops. Go ahead. Everything's got a life of its own. Watch out for this.
Oh, sure. We have a life of its own.
And John's going to call him. Yeah, I think Crystal's coming. So she'll fill in.
Products. I haven't seen it since we left. I was so glad to see those trailers get right out of here.
That's
go this way. You want to go this way, Justin? See what's happening? And everything was
happening.
Hi,
Terry.
How are you? Good. Yeah. Last time was different circumstances.
Yeah. I was afraid they would play.
That's when we were on the present.
I'm not telling you.
I know, I shouldn't say that, but I can do that.
How are you?
Very good, how are you?
Thank you.
This is mean to me about everybody to come together and hang out and enjoy the party.
This place is gonna be a real joy, and I thank you for making this for us.
Hi, I'm Miranda, by the way, Miranda Hudson, and I live in Enfield, New Hampshire, and I work at Kendall in Hanover, and I think Bark is a great thing, and because I like to get together with my friends. Am I right, Trevor? Your turn.
My name is Trevor Klinick. I work at Place Software, and I like to be with friends, and I think Quark is a good place to hang out and have fun.
See the Spark Community Center. It's a good, great place to get together with people. It's great for community.